What's happening, everybody? Trey here, joined by my dad, Sean. And today, reactions to the classics. Got another song battle in store. And today, Dad, gonna get a bit of a Brazilian flavor on.
That's right. I'm gonna let you pronounce this one, Trey. I'm gonna give you the honor.
Well, we'll do our best here. We got Adeus, Maria Fulo by the Brazilian band Os Mutantes versus Tropicalia by Beck, who, you know, we're familiar with Beck. Not familiar with old Os Mutantes. So looking forward to diving into it. And I want to shout out our long time friend and patron of the channel, David, for suggesting this battle for us today. And we've done a lot of non-English language type of stuff, so you know, that part won't be new, even though the band here, Os Mutantes, is.
Yeah, and I mean, I don't have anything on this song. I went to a lot of places for research and maybe I just couldn't find it, but we're gonna have the lyrics up, as always, the English lyrics, and the translation is "Goodbye, Maria Fulo."
Yes, looking forward to this, and then afterwards we'll get our back on and take it from there.
Let's do it.
Those birds are chirping and tweeting.
Really brings you in.
It was interesting on this, Dad, because the first, 45 seconds, we just set a bit of the atmosphere with the birds.
Birds, and that's what I said. So it should be in a Disney movie. What I was referencing, it should be in the Jungle Book. I feel this rainforest.
No, you're right,
and just this fun little vibe to it. Now, the lyrics themselves aren't really a fun vibe because it says, "Goodbye, I'm taking off, baby, crying, can't do anyone any good, wipe away your tears of pain, that the drought barely started. As we always say, when lyrics are translated, you know, I don't know if that's the exact translation from Portuguese, but we're just trusting the site that we use. It seems pretty trustworthy.
Well, and if he's saying the drought's barely started, that means more tears are probably on the way. More pain is on the way, and he knows goodbye. I'm taking off, Maria, and he calls her the flower of his heart. I'll be back any day, but who knows, man? Who knows if he's really gonna be back here? Interesting. We had a lot of different type of kind of keys, almost like a vibraphone sounding in there.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say.
You know, so some very rich textures, and not that I know much Brazilian music, but this is kind of how I would expect it to
me
sound.
Too. Me too. And it just, even though like we said, the lyrics are heavy. For us that can't understand the lyrics, you know, besides the translation, almost a feel-good song or the atmosphere or mood, which I know is kind of what you were getting at.
No, and I think that was apparent in the vocals as well,
yes.
Where, again, you kind of felt like you were maybe not on the streets of Brazil, but, you know, something along
those... A little bit of a good time.
Along those lines, man. So we'll see now what Beck has in store with Tropicalia, where he was kind of quite inspired by Brazilian music, and he even cited Os Mutantes as being a bit of an inspiration for this song.
Yeah, he said the inspiration also was, I've always loved a lot of different exotic music. I've been listening to Brazilian music since I was a kid, so that's interesting. But I haven't really felt it was something that would come naturally until the last few years. I think for something like this song, I need to go to places where that music existed in order to get to the point where I could do it myself. I wrote it in the back of the bus on a tour, and then I later put lyrics to it. A lot of times I write the melody and the chords of songs sometimes years before I get around to writing the lyrics, so it just sits there incubating. One of the interesting things, Beck does not play any instrument on this song.
Okay, man. So let's see what we got.
The streets, the reek of tropical charms, the embassies lying hideous yards where tourists snore and decay. And when they dance in a reptile blaze, you wear a mask, an equatorial haze into the past, a colonial maze where there's no more confetti to throw. You wouldn't know what to say to yourself. Love is a poverty you couldn't sell. Misery waits in the hotel. You're out of luck, you're singing funeral songs to the studs. They're anabolic and bronze, they seem to strut in their millennial fogs till they fall down and deflate. You wouldn't know what to say to yourself. Love is a poverty you couldn't sell. Misery waits in big hotels. We love it. Oh, and now you've had your fun under an air-conditioned sun. It's burned into your eyes, leaves you plain and left behind. I see them rise and fall into the jaws of a past and then love. You wouldn't know what to say to yourself. Love is a poverty you couldn't sell. Misery waits in big hotels to be a victim.
Interesting, we're already out of lyrics, so we're gonna repeat, I guess.
Instrumentally as well.
Mm-hmm.
right, Tropicalia coming in here. What did you think of this, Dad? I know you're a bit lukewarm when it comes to Beck. So I'm curious your take on
this. Well, you took the words out of my mouth. You know, it's interesting. The first song builds for 45 seconds at the start. This has about a minute and a half coda at the end where they just kind of throw everything in the kitchen sink in there. I mean, you just said it. I'm just not a Beck guy. Now, I will say this. I did a song reaction of Beck and gave it the highest rating I've ever given a song reaction. So you can't say that I'm not at least a little bit open to the man, but I just didn't feel it, man. I wasn't feeling it. What about you?
I mean, I think I enjoyed it more than you did.
Well, I think that's probably a given. I mean, I didn't hate it, but...
It lived up to its name, the tropical type of sound that that we had rocking and rolling in there. A lot of different stuff, from even like synthesizers to obviously all the kind of bells going off at the end to, I think, try to give that almost Brazilian type of atmosphere.
It felt a little forced, whereas the first song felt natural because obviously they are Brazilian. Yeah. To me, it felt a little forced to create that atmosphere, but what do I know? I'm not Beck. He's a master musician. He definitely is. So.
No, and I can see where you're coming from on that regard, though. You know, I could see how this could be viewed as a bit derivative, you know, trying to take it where, obviously, Os Mutantes, it's their straight up culture.
Well, yeah, they have a heck of an advantage, you know. Yeah, for sure.
But he puts out a lot of lyrics in a short amount of time, too.
Verse 2 is interesting.
Yeah, I mean, this came out in 98, so kind of roasting the millennials before it was cool.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. You're out of luck. You're singing funeral songs to the studs. They're anabolic and bronze. They seem to strut in their millennial fog, so they fall down and deflate. So, I mean, I'm getting these roided up guys strutting around, and then they fall down and die, basically.
And he notes, love is a poverty you couldn't sell. Misery waits in Bake Hotel. So both songs kind of have that, like, get ready to cry, almost essentially, you know, stuff's like on the surface. Oh, man, this tropical setting is going to be great. Maybe the grass isn't always greener.
It is definitely not.
The other side here. So I already know, Dad, who you're likely going to choose here.
Yeah, Trey, didn't leave a lot of drama. The Os Mutantes, and that's definitely what I'm going with.
Yeah, man, I'm trying to think here, man.
Don't give it a lot of thought.
What if I guess I'm going Os Mutantes, too.
Yeah, but it's nothing against Beck. The song's not horrible, guys. I don't want to get framed up kind of the way I present. It's not a horrible song. I get what he's trying to do.
I liked in both tracks, but in Close Battles, I kind of go to the originals.
Right.
And I got to go Os Mutantes, which, you know, inspired old Beck here. But
yeah.
An interesting battle, man, going to the land of Brazil here. Let us know which of these you have on top, and be sure to show David some love in the comments for suggesting this. And if you'd like to have us do a song battle or reaction for you, you can check out our Patreon page. Shout out to all the patrons who help keep the channel rocking and rolling. That'll be at the end screen along with another video you might enjoy. But Dad, I guess that'll wrap it up.
That's it
for us today, and until next time, thanks for watching, happy listening, and we will see you.